Back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a question sent in by George. If you have a question for the Netcast, please feel free to drop me an email, leave me a voicemail, and we'll get to you on a future podcast. So, George works in a customer service department where they have a number of customers, and he'd like to be able to send out birthday cards to all of his regular customers. And he'd like to be able to do this about a week ahead of time. Now, in George's database here, he has a list of customers and their birthday, but when he tries to use any function like perhaps the today function, equal today, minus the birth date to see if anything's in the next 7 days or something like that, we're getting strange answers. First of all, let's format this just as a number so we can see how many days away the birthday is. Click OK, and we get a huge number like 23,000. Well, that's saying that this customer was born 23,000 days ago, and George really just wants to know if their birthday is coming up in the next 7 days. So what we have to do is we have to come up with a calculation that will figure out when their birthday falls this year. So I'm going to insert a new column, and I'm going to call it birthday 2007, and we're going to use the date function. The date function is this fabulous function in Excel where we give it a year, a month, and a day. So I'll ask for the date, 2007, and then which month do I want? I want the month from the customer's birthday, so I'll ask for the month function of B2, and then which day do I want? Again, I want the day of the customer's birthday, so I'll ask for the day of B2. So basically what I'm asking for here is the 2007th year, the sixth month, the second day, and that will give me a date that falls in this year, so that this year the customer's birthday is June 2nd, 2007. Now, when I change my formula to compare today to the customer's birthday, equal birthday minus today, I'm going to get the actual number of days from now until the birthday. So for example, in row 3, Bobby's birthday is 154 days from now, not time to send the card yet. So I'll call this days away, and perhaps what I'll do is sort ascending, and basically then I'll look for any customers whose birthdays are coming up in the next 7 days. So Anita and Sarah send out their birthday cards now. Now when I come back in next week and open this, of course the today function is going to recalculate, so I'll just have to resort the data, and very quickly again I'll be able to find those customers whose birthdays are coming up again. The key to this was to use the date function. Again, that was date, and then we specify a year, a month, and a day. In this case, I'm reusing the month and day from column B, the actual birthday, but in the year, putting 2007. So thanks to George for sending in that question, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.